It was, we were doing it there the other day.
Yeah.
You still see it?
Do you imagine it?
You hold up your phone, you're certified.
Well, that's just.
Okay.
Edit in a flag.
All the flags in the hall.
There it is. Sunshine Law Statement, all requirements of the Open Public Business, I don't know why I said it, Open Public Meetings Act have been met for this meeting of the Board of Education in the Borough of Orno. Notice this meeting was filed with the Record and Town News of all persons requesting such notice. Mrs. Walker, would you read the mission statement?
The Orno Public School District, a safe and nurturing learning community dedicated to the ongoing pursuit of educational excellence, inspires lifelong learning in its children through comprehensive, innovative curriculum and instruction. The district fully supports and expects the attainment of the New Jersey Core Curriculum Content Standards on the part of all students within a school environment designed to maximize student potential, develop responsible citizens, and promote respect for the uniqueness of all individuals.
Thank you. Roll call.
Mr. Griffin?
Yes.
Mrs. Norian?
Here.
Mr. Odo?
Here.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Here.
Mrs. Walker?
Here.
Mr. Walsh?
Here.
Dr. Wesley?
Yes.
Mrs. Robertson?
Here.
Mrs. Nichols?
Here. Open to the public for agenda items only.
Oh my gosh, well, you know, the thing is.
There's a big wait to come to the mic, so you better get up here.
Well, Nikki's at a retirement dinner. She's on her way. Carol had to teach. She's coming in any day. But with regards to our renting the space for the summer, is there.
No, you have to write your name down.
Oh, right, okay, sorry.
And state your name.
That's true, I'm sorry about that. I used to get called that. Hi, you think I need to do Chris Schlegel, and I'm here representing all the roles of stage. And as you know, we would love to be able to rent the theater for the summer. I understand, of course, that because we are for-profit, there's a specific amount that we have to pay. That's understandable. But we were wondering if there was any way we could come to some kind of compromise with the air conditioning fee. First of all, I noticed during the play that it was actually freezing in here. I mean, I don't know if anyone else.
Yes, Dr. Westlake, he was in the front row, and I was like, oh, you know, too.
Freezing. And I was like, well, I wonder what the temperature was set at. Now, I know during the summer, according to what we've heard, it's set at 78. But that's not really going to work for children who are in, for anyone who's in this building, because especially once we get the lights going and on stage, it's going to be too hot. But then we're thinking to ourselves, oh my God, it was like 55 degrees. Not really 55 degrees, but it was very cold. So is there any way we could compromise on the degree of the degree, like let's say it could be 70 or something along those lines. I mean, I don't know when you air condition is normally, what is the temperature that you set at? Do you know?
Yes. Okay, so when we're not using it, we set it to 78.
Correct.
When we are using it, then we set it to 72. And so when the board asked me to research what it would cost to cool the room, I contacted Johnson Controls because they were the ones who managed our recent ESIP project and oversaw the installation of the air conditioning in the auditorium in the first place. And they're also the ones who have the contract to monitor our energy savings over the next several years. So they had the exact formula for calculating precisely what it would cost to cool the room on a daily basis during the 8 months that they term cooling season months. And so Johnson Controls reports a cost to the State Department of Education of $31 per day to cool this one room. And so when we calculated the cost of what it would be, And we multiplied that by the 24 days in your application. That's where we got $744 total cost. So what, you know, it's obviously up to the board to decide whether they want to come up with a different amount. However, if we were cooling the room for the whole day on each of the days that you're proposing to use it, Johnson Controls has told me that the proper amount to be reported to the state would be $31 a day or $744 total. So there are certainly ways to compromise. If the board decided they wanted to do that, they could. Or the other thing that I think we've already discussed in another conversation was that it's also possible to simply use the room on fewer days. So it's not, I mean, I think it would be worthwhile to consider whether maybe doing just the final week of the program and your performance in this room, and then doing other, you know, rehearsals in other places would be a great way to save money.
Well, okay, a couple of things. So the formula that they've come up with, that's $31 a day, how many hours a day is that?
It's for a day.
For a day. So it would be a school day, which would be, what, hypothetically, I guess, well, it's 8:30 to 3:00. But we're here for four.
Can I ask a question? Yeah. What are you asking us specifically?
I would like to compromise on the air conditioning.
Meaning the $744?
I understand that. We understand the policy as far as $50 an hour.
I totally get it.
I understand a custodian overtime, totally get it. Mm-hmm.
But you know what, if you're renting the room in the winter, you don't ask people to pay for heat. And you do have this air on to a certain degree. I know you have it 78.
Stop talking, because the more you talk, sometimes it gets bad. You ever watch Shark Tank? So my opinion, I don't know if we can discuss this now. Can we discuss this?
Well, I wouldn't make a final decision at this time.
May I make one point before you discuss it? Is that okay? I thought Nikki and Carol also thought about the fact of rehearsing elsewhere and then moving the show in. Part of the draw, I mean, we have children from Bramson, Dumont, and we even had Mahwah and River Ridge and what have you. It's not Oradell, all Oradell students. But we do probably 80% of the run more now. So there are a lot of people who are interested in the camp because I think it's a great product, but also it's a great camp. But also that it's a walking distance, a biking distance, and what have you. And so we would start at River Edge and then move here. It kind of would lose some of the appeal to some of the people who expressed interest in them not.
And if you also want to have stuff, and then you'd be able to rent a truck again. It's a whole other moving day. So it's to us, it's either we do it here or we keep it in River Edge. I think that that's our decision because there were.
So yes, we are asking if we could make some kind of compromise on the air conditioning. It's fewer hours than has been figured out.
Yes. So I'm going to tell you this. I think we would be much more open to that. I can't make you a promise right here because I'm one person out of nine and it would have to go to committee, but I think maybe we could do that quick and get back to you quick so you know.
Because that's Dorothy, that's...
We're still going to approve this just so we have it because we can always, we want to approve the building use.
Okay, great.
Okay, like we'll approve it because you need to know, but give us a little bit of time. I think that could... I'm not going to talk to the board and to the committee, but I think maybe we could do that.
I know this might not be the time for questions. This has nothing to do with that. It has to wind it.
Well, can't you wait till I tell you how great it was? But go ahead.
I want you to, this has nothing to do, but it's the time I'm standing up. I just came teaching a piano lesson, so I basically threw the kid out the door.
That's a very
I'm like, you have to go now.
I do a post reflection on what their performance was. And I really only had, yesterday I ran a fall festival at the university, so I was here. So
I only had 2 days of it, but you would not believe the things that they have put down. And I just wanted to share with you, because you have really supported our efforts in letting us have the kids. Some of you have seen the performance. It's so much more than what they did. So if you want to just take them and pass them.
I also mentioned how there were problems about shy children getting up.
Yes, yes, yes.
I have to say, like, I went to, who saw The Lion King?
Oh, wow.
Okay, and you were away, yes, so almost all of us. But I have to say, I knew it was going to be good, but I have to say, it exceeded my, surpassed my expectations. And I have to say, like, we have some talented kids.
Oh, well, we
but they didn't start out that way.
Yeah, I was going to say, because, and I think this one was actually better than a lot of some of the other ones. It was
you know,
really good.
People love the show.
It was really good.
But if you saw, like, we have kids, I mean, some of those kids are camp, that is a piece of their development. But like we have one or two campers that used to cry in the beginning.
Yeah.
Their parents would stay
yeah.
with them, and they had one of the solos up there, and another child that never sang it for a month before.
Yeah, no, some of them were amazing.
Another one started out as an outer seller.
And one of them, one of the boys was saying, I'm not home like every other day for like 3 weeks because I couldn't be able to do it. And then finally, they come in. You know, so the joy for me was seeing the development of the kid.
Yeah,
you know, like the character was not there. They learned. Chris is amazing as far as getting children to act and react, we always say. So when they say, I feel so proud of myself, but the thing I love most about being here is learning to work in a group. You know, I learned what it was to have teamwork. I learned what it was that, you know, you don't like everybody when you start out, but you work with them anyway. To work as one, not to be selfish. You know, it's just, if you sometimes get a moment to meet some of these, it's just, to my heart, it's like, oh, you know, this is so
I love it. I learned that you don't have to be a main part.
Yes, that's
yeah.
great. That's awesome.
Because in the beginning, some of them are like, they're very little. I can tell you, like, Lord's friend, stop down the stage.
Like a little kid that was in the foster hand that goes,
remember?
Yeah. I said, just wait, it's going to be great. But you got to wait until it happens.
Yeah.
So anyway, I type up a couple of them for you.
What?
Okay, sorry.
You have to.
I have a follow-up procedure.
Okay. Sorry.
Could I just share one thing?
Yeah.
I came to the dress rehearsal because I wasn't going to be here. And the dress rehearsal went so smoothly. And I sat in the back and Mr. Walsh had invited some of the senior
yes.
citizens.
Yes.
So I sat next to one of our senior citizens. And she said, I am left speechless
aww.
By the performance. And she is very intuitive. And she also said, not only is there so much talent here, but she was amazed at the teamwork of the staff and of the children and Mr. Butcher running back
yes.
and forth back.
And really involved in our summers.
So, I mean, here's a senior citizen and she's quite articulate and has a son, a grandson, who is in stage. And she said, it was just amazing. So, thank you.
You know, you start here, this one you leave, then you leave, you go here, then you come back, and then you come back here, and, you know, it's what makes it. I'm so glad you all got to be a part of it.
It was amazing.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
We'll be your audience for the rest of the year.
It might not be as good of a performance.
Oh, well, okay.
Yeah, that's true.
You guys want to talk together?
I don't know.
I'm just curious.
No, I've been around here.
We go together.
Okay.
Any awesome. Other comments on the agenda? Well, for the public. Yeah, that's the vote for agenda items only, so I guess not.
Yeah, I guess I vote
for okay, so, all right, so my remarks were going to be the play, so we already went through that and how amazing it was. The other thing is, it's Memorial Day weekend, which I realize we're doing the parade. Have we heard anything? There's no parade?
No.
What happened?
The town of at first.
I'm not sure that
you can to the ceremonies, but
what?
I believe that the town felt that the parade really was very small and not too well attended, so they wanted to put more emphasis on the, well, but for Memorial Day, put more emphasis on the different memorials. So they will be having a dedication and a memorial at each of the monuments, but there's no formal parade. And I think, for me, I think it makes more sense that people, maybe more people will come, knowing they don't have to figure out a parade, and will just go from monument to monument.
Okay, no parade. That's good.
I've always felt that it was a ceremonial thing, and thus why I didn't ever wear the OPF shirt. To me, it's a more somber event, and I know that I will still be at the memorial dressed for the event, because I think that's something that we should do, and I think as a Board of Education that we may want to consider showing up as a group in support of our veterans.
Okay, let's move to the superintendent's report.
Okay, thank you. The one thing I wanted to remind everyone of is that on June 6th, we will have the last of our strategic planning sessions. And so I wanted to remind everybody who may have already answered our survey saying that they were going to attend that if you haven't been to any of the others or only one session perhaps, it doesn't matter, you're still able to participate fully in this next meeting. So anybody who is interested in attending is most welcome. And then also, I wanted to report that our total student enrollment as of April 2018 was 746. The student attendance rate for the month of April was 94.11, and our staff attendance rate for the month of April was 96.72. And that concludes my report.
Business administrator's report?
No report.
Thank you. Minutes review of April 25th and May 9th. Any comments? You can email Vishoni, committee reports. Buildings and grounds, Mr. Odo. Second by Mr. Walsh. Any questions? Call the question.
Mr. Griffin?
Yes.
Mrs. Norian?
Yes.
Mr. Odo?
Yes.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
Mr. Walsh?
Yes.
Dr. Wesley? Yes. Mrs. Robertson?
Yes.
Mrs. Nichols?
Yes. Curriculum, Mrs. Walker?
Yes. I'd like to present C1.
Second by Mr. Walsh. Any questions? Call the question.
Mr. Griffin?
Yes.
Mrs. Norian?
Yes.
Mr. Odo?
Yes.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
Mr. Walsh?
Yes.
Dr. Wesley?
Yes.
Mrs. Robertson?
Yes.
Mrs. Nichols?
Yes. Finance, Mrs. Shapiro?
I just wanted to do a quick summary. So Finance met last week, and one item added to your agenda is D7. We decided to go with a different computer financial software. And quick background on this, you'll see the initial outlay is $38,000. Take all of these expenses very seriously and are very aware of the limitations with the current outlay.
It's low, sorry, my volume was down. Okay, thank you. So the one thing we really liked about this software is that with the cost savings, after year three, we're saving $11,000 a year. So this is widely approved software. It gives us a lot more flexibility. The auditors approved it. And like I said, while there is the initial outlay going forward after year three, it's $11,000 in savings. So with that, I would like to move items D1 through D7.
Dr. Wesley with a second. Any questions? Call the question.
Mr. Griffin?
Yes.
Mrs. Norian?
Yes.
Mr. Odo?
Yes.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
Mr. Walsh? Okay, Dr. Wesley?
Yes.
Mrs. Robertson?
Yes.
Mrs. Nichols?
Yes, delegate report, Mr. Walsh.
I attended two meetings last week. May 17th was the New Jersey School Board's PTA meeting at the War Memorial. And the school board did a good job. They got about 20 legislators. But they could have done better. They don't have, we didn't have anybody from Bergen County. What was discussed was school funding, special ed course, and school safety. And they formed a committee on school safety moving forward. That's going to be the topic, the latest topic, although the school funding meetings are being held around the state in the Senate Board. Then on the 19th, I attended the delegates assembly, and I handed it out. I never got my packet, so I couldn't pick it up at the meeting. But what we discussed was two resolutions. There were actually 8 resolutions presented. 2 regarding guns were rejected, and 4 didn't fit the New Jersey School Board's policy scope, so they were rejected. But the 2 that remained, one was brought by Manchester about the getting the school board to step forward, and you can read the recommendation. There were 147 delegates in 20 counties, and this resolution with all the changes and the amendments to the changes and the amendments to those amendments took about 2 hours. Finally, they stayed with the New Jersey School Board's findings. I didn't vote for the findings. I voted for the changes because it had specific things about guns and what do you call it. But the resolution, and then the other resolution, and that went over 186. There were about 40 people that had walked out during the discussion. Then Chesterfield had the second resolution, and Chesterfield is a town that's been underfunded for about 15 years. I don't know where they've been, but they've been underfunded in millions of dollars. So the taxpayers have been shouldering the cost. And that won 95-5. So 47 more people walked out before that vote was taken. So there was 100 people, 100 delegates there by the end of the vote. But next year I promise that we will get the meeting before that I go to the delegates assembly. We will discuss the resolutions that have got to be voted on. That's what I have to do. I had the banner back, but I crossed that off. Maybe I'll take
it home. Maybe.
Choose to come home
and take it more. All right, thank you. Personnel, Mrs.
Robertson? Yes, I'd like to present to the board F1 through F5.
Second. Mr. Walsh, second. Any questions? Call the question.
Mr. Griffin?
Yes.
Mrs. Nourian?
Yes.
Mr. Odo?
Yes.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
Mr. Walsh?
Yes.
Dr. Wesley?
Yes.
Mrs. Robertson?
Yes.
Mrs. Nichols?
Yes. Policy, Mr. Griffin?
Yes. We're submitting for first read a set of policies. There's one policy in here that we're still going to be reviewing a little bit more, the wellness nutrition policy. So that's not going to be first read right now, but the ones that are up for first read are the visitors, operation and maintenance of plants, safety, harassment, intimidation, and bullying, and child study team. This came out of a review from New Jersey School Board Association that we were looking at all our policies, what needed some updates. And these were ones that they had some guidance on. The other thing that's going on is we are in policy waiting for Strauss Esme to give us a wellness check so we can compare their results versus New Jersey School Boards Association. And at some point, we may consider switching to their system to manage our policies. Just wanted to update you on that.
Thank you. Mrs. Walker?
Jeremy, is there a difference in cost between the two?
So right now, there is a minor difference in cost. And Strauss Esme used to be a lot more expensive than the New Jersey School Board Association. But now their prices have come more in line, depending on the services that we're going to get. And the services, basically, there's a lot of back-end office things that are happening now that, like, whenever we pass a resolution or we pass a new policy, all of that has to be updated by our staff. There's a lot of staff time that goes into that and maintaining all of this. Strauss Esme has some services that clean that up a little bit more. Dr. Ansel can tell you a little bit more about the difference, but that's my understanding at this point. And we're not recommending at this point that we'd switch, just something we're considering.
Any other questions? Public Relations, Mrs. Dorian?
I was just looking for my summary, but I don't have it with me. We had met just a couple weeks ago, and I've had a graduation in between, so I'm not sure I remember. So if you could,
sure. A couple of the highlights from our recent meeting were talking about some of the upgrades to the website that Zulu's been working on, and in addition, we also spoke about planning for our next newsletter, and we also spoke about communications around the strategic planning meetings, both leading up to our last one, and then also communications following the last one to push out some of the results.
Oh, and don't forget, we also included with the discussion about getting the board photograph ticket.
Oh, I can update on that. I was in touch with him. Yeah. Okay, so this is busy season. I have him pinned down for June 13th. I'm just confirming the time. I haven't heard that, but if the meeting starts at 7:30, we just need to give him maybe 7 o'clock. Let me just confirm, and Dr. Ansel will email everybody. I hope everybody can come. It would be nice to have a full house for the photo, June 13th. But if something comes up, you know, he may have to cancel last minute. We just, you know. I have a question on, not the website, but one thing we were talking about was an app. When I was on PR, the app for the phone, is there a time frame for that?
Yes. The timeline is that there would be some kind of a beta version that we could test that would come out in early summer, so that we have at least about 4 to 6 weeks to have some people practice with it. And then the goal is to be able to release it officially just prior to the start of next school year.
Be lovely.
Anything else?
That's it.
Dry District, Dr. Westlake. Open to the public.
Thank you. didn't have to include it. They couldn't determine that it was proprietary. Everyone believes it's proprietary, they all do the same thing, and under the law of proprietary. It might be from here, but I understand why the county is doing that, but it's confusing, because if you poll 50% of the state, they'll say they give it under proprietary exclusion.
Is that because of the amount of yours, though? Because yours was 80 and ours is under 40.
They're doing it, obviously, you want to be, you still have to procure it a certain way. Now, there isn't any law written for public, for procurement of quotes, if it's proprietary. But next year, there are fees, so in a two-year contract, you're over $40,000. Are they saying that's it, we're going to give maintenance for free? Probably not. Just have to be careful, and I understand why you're, why it happened, because we went through a lot. My DA was trying to get us to see if we could do proprietary and exclusive, but finally, as it was no, we were not to regular. We did RFP for it, actually. We had people present stuff to us. I think they copied it on the board that I, and we were on the CSI, we received free proposals. So, again, I just might want to be careful in case somebody questions that. Like I said, we just want to do it.
Thank you. Okay, home business.
I'm not sure if it's old or new, but about the dinner that's planned for next week for our two honorees, John Walsh and Dr. Westlake. I need a head count, and Jean, would you like to share why you won't be coming?
He doesn't have to tell us.
Oh, well,
I don't have to tell you, but I have to apologize. I gave the wrong information. I thought the program was tomorrow night and not next week.
What's next week's date?
31st.
So I don't have to tell you any of the story.
You can come?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you can come now?
To get honored.
And this is, well, who did I speak to? Mrs. Schoening.
It's
yes.
Thursday.
Yeah.
It's a week from tomorrow night, the
30th. 6:30 in
Hasbro
Heights.
Yes, at the Hilton.
And Mrs. Schoening is going to call to get all the details for what you were asking the other night.
Okay, so you're going to take care of it, Mrs. Schoening, and I'm going to bother to call, see if we can get it.
Who is going?
Yeah, I think we should get a head count.
May 31st.
Can we all have us at the same table?
Jean, I'll pick you up.
I don't want to sit with you. Any other old business?
Should be in the play.
I should go to the theater program this summer.